the Master's Touch Evensong service. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be pleasing to you, O Lord. Did you come expecting to receive tonight? Well, if not, then you won't receive anything from God. So elevate your expectation level and open your hearts to receive Him. And if you don't know what Vespers and Evensong services are, Let me just quickly tell you that they are Vespers is a spoken service held in the late afternoon and early evening. And Evensong is an evening service that is primarily done in song. In other words, the songs contain or point to the message. Under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, we're bringing you a composite, a service that combines Vespers and Evensong. And we pray that you enjoy it and will join us often. Now, as we begin our worship tonight, take a second to assemble a small piece of bread or cracker and a swallow of some sort of beverage or juice. Set it aside. Later on, we're going to pray over it, sanctifying it as the body and the blood of Christ. But right now, let's worship our King, shall we?
Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord, our Maker. Come, let us worship and bow down, before the Lord, our Maker. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord, our Maker. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord, our Maker. He is our God. We are the people of His pasture. He is our God. He is our God. We are the sheep of His hand. Worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord, our Maker.
But no longer thou must change.
I will sing your praise forever. Open my lips, O Lord. I will sing your praise forever.
Stop what you're doing, pull up a chair, and get ready to receive. You know, we've entered God's presence with praise and thanksgiving, folks, and now as we dwell in God's presence, just embrace the sweetness of the Holy Spirit. Bask in His presence and open your hearts to receive Him. Thank you.
to reach someone like me. If you had not walked upon this broken ground, where on earth would I be now? If you had not come, if you had not come to seek the sick and lame, to set the captive free, to break the prisoner's chains, well, I'd still be in the dark, grappling for the door, longing for some way, somehow. But love came.
To know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, just repeat this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you as a sinner and surrender my life to you. I believe that you are the Son of God. I believe that you died for me and set me free for all eternity from all my sin, past, present, and future. I believe that you rose from the dead and sit at the right hand of God the Father. Take over my life and cleanse me of all unrighteousness. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. I renounce the devil and all sin. Lord, I receive from you the gift of righteousness, total forgiveness of all my sins, past, present, and future, divine health, wholeness, and restoration, your protection, direction, your provision, and your peace, and the gift of everlasting life. I'm yours. Come into my heart, take over my life. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. If you prayed that prayer with me, then you're saved. Welcome to the family of God. Rejoice. Well, before we go forward, I want to say to you that I realized that I just did an entire sermon with my microphone off. So I'm going to continue on with this tonight. We'll finish this broadcast, but I'm not going to post it up. I will do a podcast of this service and put it up for later. You can go in and listen to it. I apologize. I just can't seem to remember to turn it back on when I play some of the music. So forgive me, but we will go forward and take care of that, okay? But right now, we're gonna continue on because it's time to listen to what we have to say about Holy Communion. I want you to listen to the words of this song because it tells you everything you're ever going to want to know about why you take it.
Behold the Lamb who bears our sins away, slain for us. And we remember the promise made that all who come in faith find forgiveness at the cross. And so we share in this bread of life, and we drink sacrifice as a sign of our bonds of peace around the table of the King. The body of our Savior Jesus Christ tore that healed, the death that brings us life, paid the price to make us one. Love the King.
one of the wonderful things that we receive from taking Holy Communion is healing of our bodies and our minds. And the issue with those who take Holy Communion and don't receive their healing through it is rooted in lack of knowledge. We must prepare before taking Holy Communion, and the first thing we absolutely must do is discern the body of Christ. Now, what does that mean, and how do we do that? Well, we need to acknowledge that the bread or whatever you're using as the body of Christ is the vibrancy of the life of Jesus Christ, his divine healing and wholeness and wellness, his supernatural healing, all that perfection that is his is yours in that one little piece of bread or whatever it is you're using, like I said, that he is, his attributes, his character, everything that is him is in that, and it's your portion. And you could think of it as a pill that's glowing with the Shekinah glory of God. It's healing you as it travels through your mouth, down into your body. It's pushing out all darkness, which is sickness and disease, from the inside out. Now visualize the condition you're plagued with, the sickness or disease being on Jesus' body. This is what we've been talking about. Then put whatever the ailments are on him. Use your imagination. You're not giving him something he doesn't want. Don't feel guilty about it. He already took it at the cross, remember? And he was glad to do it. You see, the enemy's trying to trick you. He's trying to trick you into taking it. How? By deceiving you into thinking you've got it. But I want you to know that since Jesus took it already at the cross, you're healed and made whole already. So you don't have to worry about that. So put it back on Jesus, right in the same place on him you've been afflicted. In other words, see yourself with the solution, folks. See yourself without the problem. It's called spiritual visualization. Here's the key to it. Number one, visualize. Get that picture of yourself healed and whole. Then meditate on what God's word says about it and you. In other words, that you were healed at the cross because what Jesus did at the cross for you, his completed and finished work, was on your behalf. That you are healed and made whole because of that. Then pray in tongues. Number three, pray in tongues over it. Then decree it by speaking out the revelation of your healing and restoration. Make your declaration out loud. It's vital that you understand this and do it. The next thing we do in preparation is discern the blood of Christ. We discern it as the forgiveness of all sin, past, present, and future, as restoration of the blessing to your life, the power and the authority of God in your life in full operation, as receiving the gift of righteousness from Jesus Christ, thanking God for his plan of redemption, that you've been given eternal life, life everlasting. And now, you no longer live under the law, but you live under his grace. So that everything you do is under his grace. And the more that you do, the more he graces you, the more he gives you blessings. Now lift up the elements of the covenant before the Lord that I asked you to assemble at the beginning of the program, and I'm going to pray over them. Father, we praise you and worship you with these elements of the covenant. We thank you that your only begotten Son, Jesus, gave his life sacrificially so that we may live and have life more abundantly. We thank you now as this bread becomes our portion of his healing body. And the vibrancy of his life within us. And we thank you that as we partake of the body of Christ, we become healed and made whole, completely restored. We thank you that this beverage becomes our portion of his cleansing blood, that we are continually washed in the waterfall of his blood and renewed within as we perpetually remember his act of love on the cross on our behalf. In the name above all names, the matchless name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen. Now, the Lord's Supper is a personal fellowship. It's a partnership with Christ. Partaking of one bread creates partnership between the members as well. It merges us all into one body, the church. Now, the Word of God commands us to eat the bread and drink the cup. Do this, perform this action, continually take the bread, give thanks, and break it, and eat it. Then take the cup, give thanks, and drink it, all in the remembrance of Jesus. The Lord commanded that the supper be repeated often. However, Paul really didn't give us any instruction as to how frequently the Lord's Supper is to be celebrated. But he does imply that it's to be done with frequency so that partaking of the Lord's Supper continually recalls to our mind our redemption by Christ from all sickness, all disease, and all sin. So do it as often as you want to and need to. As we're instructed, we discern the body and the blood of Christ as we prepare to partake. On the night that he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." The body of our Lord Jesus Christ broken for you so that every cell, every tissue, every organ, and every bone are totally aligned with God's word and his will, that you are and remain healed, made whole, and totally restored to divine health and wholeness. In the name of Jesus, our healer, the Christ, amen. Partake of the body of our Lord and Savior. In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. The blood of our Lord Jesus, shed for you in the celebration of the finished work of Jesus on the cross, for the remission of all of your sins, past, present, and future. In the name of Jesus, our Redeemer and Savior, the Christ. Amen. Partake of the blood of our Lord and Savior." The Lord's Supper is a feast, my friends. That's right. Excuse me. A feast of living union of believers with the Savior, whereby we spiritually and by faith receive Christ with all of his benefits and are nourished with the vibrancy of his life into eternal life. And for that, we are eternally grateful. Raise your hands for the blessing, my friends. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you his peace. May you open up your mouth and continually declare who you are in Christ Jesus, thanking God for all that you have received, and give honor, glory, and praise to the Lord Most High. May you glorify God with all of your thoughts, words, and deeds as the Lord continually blesses you with divine health and wholeness and makes your way prosperous as you walk in his love. In the name and majesty of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen. Join Dr. Stephanie every Sunday at 7 p.m. here on Spreaker.com for Evensong Worship. Our Evensong service is an extension of the Master's Touch Healing School of Ministry International. We are a 501c3 organization. God bless you.